Morning, dear students. In our earlier lecture, we discussed about marginal cost, marginal costing, its advantages, limitations, and important terms, and moreover, marginal cost equation, which is important to calculate practical questions. Now, in this lecture, we will lay stress upon practical aspect, how to calculate the practical questions. We will discuss over here right now. There are certain important terms which need to be given attention. Before going through the important terms, we must know what the marginal cost equation is. MCE, marginal cost equation, S minus V is equal to C is equal to F plus P. There are two sides of the marginal cost equation. Left hand side, right hand side. C is equal to S minus P or C is equal to F plus P. Now C here is denoted as contribution. Contribution therefore means excess of sales over variable cost. Mean if we deduct variable cost from sale, the result will be contribution. For example, suppose sales is rupees 200 per unit. Variable cost is rupees 110 per unit. Therefore, contribution will be S minus V. S is 200, variable cost 110, contribution per unit will be rupees 90 per unit. Now, we should discuss what are the advantages of this contribution. Why we calculate contribution? It helps in fixation of selling price. For fixation of selling price, we need contribution. Number second advantage, it help in selection of suitable sales mix. Number third important advantage is determination of a break-even point. Number four, selection of alternative method of production. Number fifth, addition of new product and drop of old product. These are the advantages of the contribution. Now the second important term which we are required to calculate in practical question is PV ratio. Other name of PV ratio is equal to contribution or marginal ratio. It is written like P oblique V PV ratio, formula C upon S multiplied by 100. C here mean contribution, S mean sales. From the marginal cost equation, we know C is equal to S minus V. By putting the value of C here, then PV ratio will be S minus V upon S multiplied by 100. By again putting the value of C from marginal cost equation, C is equal to F plus P also. By putting the value of C is equal to F plus P upon S multiplied by 100. Now, if change in profit or contribution is given in question, then we are to calculate PV ratio like this. First of all, we will write down change in profit. If in question profit is given, then we will find change in profit. If contribution is given, we will find change in contribution divided by change in sales multiplied by 100. For example, in our earlier example, contribution is 90 rupees. Contribution is written as 90 rupees. Upon sales, sales is rupees 200 divided by 200 multiplied by 100. The PV ratio will be 45%. Higher the PV ratio means higher profits. If we want to earn higher profits, our PV ratio should be on the higher side. Lower PV ratio means lower profits. Every businessman will like to increase PV ratio. How PV ratio can be increased? Number one, by increase in contribution. Arrow pointed towards upward indicate increase in contribution leads to increase in PV ratio. Number second, increase in sales leads to increase in PV ratio. Number third, decrease in variable cost will lead to increase in PV ratio. There are three alternatives through which PV ratio can be increased. Now, why we calculate PV ratio? There are certain uses, advantages of PV ratio. Number one, It helps to calculate break-even point. It provides help in the calculation of break-even point. As break-even point's formula is fixed cost upon PV ratio, therefore we require PV ratio in order to calculate break-even point. Number second, it helps to calculate fixed cost. Number third, it helps to calculate sales. Now number third, very important term, break-even point. It is a point at which there is no profit, no loss. No profit, no loss point. Break-even point can be calculated by two ways, by drawing graphs, number one. Number second, by formula. Here we will discuss second alternative, that break-even point is to be calculated with the help of formula. So first formula, break-even point in units. If we are required to calculate break-even point in units, formula will be fixed cost upon contribution per unit. If break-even point in volume or sales, rupees, is required to be calculated, then formula is fixed cost upon PV ratio. If selling price changes, then we are to calculate new contribution, because change in sale will change, result in change of contribution. Therefore we need to calculate new contribution. Now let us understand this point with the help of an example. For example, suppose fixed cost is 40,000, variable cost rupees 2 per unit, selling cost rupees 3 per unit. Now first of all, we will calculate contribution. C is equal to S minus V. S here 3, V here 2, 3 minus 2, it will be rupees 1. The formula of break-even point in unit is equal to fixed cost upon contribution per unit. Fixed cost given 40,000, contribution just calculated rupees 1, the result will be 40,000 units. Now if we are to calculate break-even point in rupees, suppose for example sales given is rupees 3 lakhs, fixed cost is given 75,000, direct material cost is also given 1 lakh, direct labor cost is also given 60,000, direct expenses rupees 40,000. We are to calculate PV ratio. First of all, we will calculate variable cost. Variable cost here is equal to direct material cost plus direct labor plus direct expenses. 1 lakh plus 60,000 plus 40,000, it will be rupees 2 lakhs. Then contribution is equal to sales minus variable cost. Sales given 3 lakhs minus variable cost just calculated, contribution will be rupees 1 lakh. PV ratio is equal to C upon S multiplied by 100. Contribution just calculated 1 lakh divided by sale already given 3 lakhs multiplied by 100. The resultant PV ratio will be 33.33%. Now we are to calculate break-even point. The formula break-even point in rupees is equal to fixed cost upon PV ratio. Fixed cost 75,000 given in question divided by PV ratio just calculated. It is 33.33%. Then the result will be rupees 2,25,000. Next, fourth important term is sales at a desired profit. Sales at desired profit. If we are to calculate sale in units, the formula is fixed cost plus desired profit divided by contribution per unit. Here we will write contribution per unit. If we are to calculate sale in rupees volume, then formula is fixed cost plus desired profit DP divided by PV ratio. Now we will understand